Battery module and battery systems often have very long process times, typically several minutes. It's physically impossible for the operator to remember every step of the process. Due to battery module and battery system assembly taking so long, it's impossible to produce them in conventional automotive manufacturing ways. That is to say, a sequential process where each worker has 30 or 40 seconds. Battery assembly is normally done with one worker and takes several minutes. That means if we want to produce lots of batteries, we need to be able to duplicate that one manufacturing process many times. Operator Guidance System, or OGS, is a piece of software that's designed to allow you to digitise a process to instruct a worker what to do. It not only gives clear instructions to the worker on what to do, it also sets the correct programs in the tools that are on the cell, and also records all the information locally or to an SQL server. OGS consists of a low-cost, permanent license runtime Windows 10 application and a separate configurator. The configurator is designed to be as simple as creating a PowerPoint presentation, meaning our customers are self-reliant and design their own processes. Product and process changes can be made at any point. Let's take a look. This is the OGS configurator. In the screen you're looking at, we define the tools that are on the station. You're allowed to have up to 32 tools. On this configuration, I've got a torque wrench, a Nexo tool, a Bluetooth caliper, a push button, and several other devices. This is the job section of the operator guidance configuration utility. Here, we can modify existing jobs in the project, or we can completely create a brand new job. We give it the job a name, and now we double click to open the job. We're going to change the background picture. And in this simple demonstration, we've got an operation where we're going to create four bolting joints, as indicated. To do this, we're going to create four tasks. And we do this by double clicking where we want the task to appear on the screen. The software auto-generates the name, and here we've got B1 to B4. You can see the icons can be moved, the size can be changed, or you can select to have them all the same size once you've decided on the final size. You can change the name of each of the tasks to anything you like. In the next step, what we do is we choose a tool that we want to use. Here, I'm using the Nexo tool, but you could use any tool that's in the station configuration. I'm going to choose Program 2 on that tool. And the third and final step is we link the operation to the task. Once we've highlighted a step, we can add text to that step. This will appear in the window in the runtime environment. This gives the worker extra guidance on what needs to be done. We can also pick the step up and move it so that the order of operation is different. When we're finished, we hit save, and then save again and save the job to the project. The third and final step is to add the job to what we call a family. The family is where we get a match on the type of product that we're expecting to manufacture. So here I've got something called Model A, which I'm going to look for in the barcode data. And you can see I can just drag the job across into this family. Here I've dragged two across, but to keep things simple, we'll just have the job that we've created, battery module one. We save the project and then we export to the runtime, and we should be able to see this run in the next video. This is the runtime environment for OGS, and the bottom bar tells us everything we need to know about the station. so we can see the worker, the station name, on-screen keyboard if we've got a touch screen, the last part processed in case we've come back from a break and we need to know if the part's been processed or not. We've got the date and time, which can be switched on or off. The logos are definable by the user, so this can be customised. And this area here where we enter the data that is going to start the process, that can be defined. 70% of the screen is actually a web page. So this can be pointed at pictures, movies, external web pages or internal web pages. So systems like and-on systems are a perfect fit for this area of the screen. But let's enter the data to start the job. So I'm now scanning in 4 barcodes to make the process start. That makes our family get selected that we used in the program, and here is the job that we created. You can see the tasks are in exactly the same position and everything looks exactly as the configurator. It's as simple as PowerPoint to use. It's now telling the Nexo tool to run programs, and you can see they're successfully running and the results are being displayed. When we get to the fourth operation, as soon as it's successfully completed, the job completes and we go back to the park screen waiting to get the next part to manufacture. So our job ran perfectly there. There were no errors. So let's introduce a not okay and see what the system does. So this is the same job that we saw before, and we're going to run the bolts in. So bolt 1 good, bolt 2 good, bolt 3, and we get a not okay, the bolts jammed. So now what operator guidance system is doing is sending an instruction to the tool to run the counterclockwise program automatically. The worker doesn't need to get involved. The bolt backs out and then the worker presses the button again to get correct operation. On the right hand side of the screen, we've also got process control. So if you're logged on as a manager, you can stop the job, clear all results, clear just one, or clear the whole process down. Here we've cleared the job down and we can start the process again. The operator guidance system has got an SQL server interface. On the database, it stores several things, and let's just run through those. The first is the results. It stores not only the tightening results, but every single thing that goes on in the process. So when someone logs on, when somebody presses a button to acknowledge a question, everything gets recorded in the database. The second function is it keeps a copy of the production status of the job. So if a battery is loaded onto one station and is only half manufactured, and then we have a material shortage and is ejected, if it then gets loaded on a different station at a different point in time, the secondary station will collect the status data from the SQL server and pick up exactly where it left off. The third feature is user credentials management. This means that we have one location to store the details of approved workers. Once they're established, they can work on any cell that's connected to that service. And the final function is all this data is available via SQL reports. That means that anyone in the organization can look at that data via a web portal. OGS is very open and very connected. It can output PDF and XML documents. It can be customized with a scripting engine. It can output files over standard IT interfaces. And it also has some industry standard protocols like OPC UA to make it easy to connect to PLCs and other systems. Operator Guidance System is a low-cost software solution that can help you digitize and control your processes. Please join us on the next video where we integrate OGS with a position control system.